Well, one of the most talked about moments of the Emmys last night was a surprise appearance from former White House Press Secretary Sean Spicer. He rolled in on a podium on stage mocking the SNL satire, which of course was of himself.
I know. Some laughed, some were shocked, some were outright disgusted. But it appears Spicer had like a hidden message in this little 30-second skit, and it was delivered using comedy.
Plenty of water cooler moments from the Emmys last night.
Unlike the presidency, Emmys go to the winner of the popular vote.
A little Indian boy from South Carolina and a little queer black girl.
Big Little Lies.
But this one's getting the most headlines.
This will be the largest audience to witness an Emmys, period.
That's Sean Spicer, and he's making fun of really himself and the alternative facts explanation he gave for the size of the inauguration crowd back in January. While the audience laughed, check Twitter, and you'll find that the most liked and most shared comments on this were not laughing at Spicer's joke. So what was Spicer doing? Was he publicly acknowledging that he lied? Was he using this to market himself? What's the underlying message here?
I think he was saying I was lying and I know it.
We visited Hamlin assistant English professor and former political speechwriter Aaron McCain, who is also working on a book chapter examining comedy in politics today.
I mean, all said, Spicer did just use comedy to try and rebrand himself.
Absolutely.
And for some people it made them mad, but for others it probably worked.
It probably worked, but it also begs the question of what makes it so funny, right? Because I think for comedy to be good has to be transgressive. And so if we laughed at Sean Spicer, if it seemed dangerous, it seemed transgressive, I think it's because he's poking fun at this idea of authenticity and this idea of the fact that we all kind of grow up as good little Boy Scouts and Girl Scouts and assume politicians are going to tell the truth, and that just isn't the era anymore.
How important is comedy in politics, and what kind of power can you get from being funny to your audience?
Humor is always incredibly important because, again, often it allows us to express the things that, for whatever reason, polite society has not allowed us to express.
In McCain's view, this is a way of Spicer coming clean, a way of saying, I'm sorry, by making fun of himself.
It's Stephen Colbert dragging out one of the most discredited figures in recent political history and getting them to admit on camera that at the end of the day, they're all sort of playing a game, and they're playing a game with the truth.
So he said it's like a hidden message in what he was saying. Spicer told the New York Times this morning, mm-hmm. in sort of a post-interview after the Emmys last night, that he does indeed regret berating accurate reports about the size of the inauguration crowd. So he's basically saying, I'm sorry, I think.
Well, as he should if he was lying. But the problem is you know, if you like Sean Spicer, if you like this administration, you might think it was funny. If you don't like Sean Spicer or the administration, you were probably one of the people that didn't think it was funny.
It was a prism of your political views.
And that's how comedy always goes.
Yeah.
If it offends you, you know, you probably don't align with that.
If it's real to you, it's funny to you.
Yeah, exactly.
Good point.